It dictates what you should wear, do, and say when going to court. Whether you're an attorney, a witness, or a defendant, courtroom etiquette are the rules that must be observed in order for the court to run as efficiently and effectively as possible. Retired Supreme Court Justice Cheryl Albury tells us why this is also important.
To put it very simply, I would say that the appropriate courtroom etiquette is behavior which fosters and promotes effective and impartial administration of justice. And of course, this should be in an environment where there is impartiality, civility, and respect for the dignity of everyone concerned.
Courtroom etiquette also takes into account how you should address judges and court officers. All things, Mrs. Albury says, an attorney is certainly not exempted.
Now, an attorney is expected to be civil. An attorney should be punctual. And also, an attorney should be prepared. There are no unimportant cases, so an attorney should prepare equally for whatever case he has to present. His papers should be in order, affidavits, etc., filed in good time.
And what about the rules pertaining to the general public?
They should observe a proper decorum. I did mention dress before. And they should be respectful. And of course, there is the need every now and then to remind persons that a courtroom is somewhere that serious business is done. It's not a place of entertainment, and chatter can be distracting to the proceedings.
We also asked a retired justice whether there are rules that apply to judges, and surprisingly enough, there are.
It is expected that judges be fair, that they be punctual as well, that they be prepared, and unfortunately, sometimes the wonderful preparation that a judge or magistrate may do is squandered when, for whatever reason, there has to be an adjournment, you know? I would also add that the judge or magistrate is in absolute command of their courtroom, but that also imposes upon them a duty to exhibit modes of conduct which are exemplary. The judge or magistrate is a human person, so from time to time they may become impatient. But it does not assist the system if you have judges or magistrates who embarrass or humiliate counsel or witnesses appearing before the court. So civility is the key at all levels.
Mrs. Albury also noted that as a judge, which spans over two decades, the most commonly broken rule was lack of preparation on the part by some attorneys. So until next week, I'm Sasha Lightborn, and now you know your rights.